Yes, good morning students. How are you all? So today we will discuss about the water pollution. So what is water pollution? First of all, we have to know about the water. What is water? Water covers about 70% of Earth's surface. Okay, and about 97.4% of total water on Earth is present in oceans, and about 0.6% of water is frozen in polar ice caps or like those of Himalayas. And next, 0.01% of total water on Earth is a fresh water. Okay, so this is the percentage of water on our Earth, means the fresh water is about 0.01%. Next, water is essential for plants and animals. As we know, the water consumed by human beings and animals should be free of impurities. Means the drinking water should not have any impurity. This impurity may be of any kind, like water which is fit for consumption should be, as you can say, there is no impurity. And should not have any adverse effect or bad effect on humans. That water is known as potable water. So first definition is potable water is that is not contaminated and good for humans. Not any toxic impurity is there. So the water obtained from natural resources. What are the natural resources from which we get the water? As you can say, the drinking water we get from lake, pond, containing, and that is safe for drinking. That doesn't have any dirt, germ or pollutants. Next, pollutants. What are the pollutants that we already discussed? Pollutant enter the water through human waste, animal dung, dead animals and other dead decaying matter, as well as through industrial waste. Next are some methods we can use to make the water for drinking, or you can say the potable water. The first method is water may be boiled for a few minutes, as most germs present in water are killed at 110 degrees Celsius. As we know that 100 degrees Celsius water boils, so at 110 degrees Celsius all the germs or some amount of germs that are present in water is killed. Water may be made pure by passing through porcelain candle, or this is a kind of candle that we used also in filters, that is also reduce the bacteria or viruses from the water. The next method is we can pass UV filters. We can pass the water through UV filters. Next, few crystals of gemsides such as potassium permanganate, okay, that we already seen in the large amount of there is gathering, so there we used in the drinking water potassium permanganate, or we can use this potassium permanganate to kill the germs. Next, excess of fluoride, that is important. Excess of fluoride may present in the groundwater in some areas. It is removed by treating water with lime. Next, chlorination. And what is chlorination? Chlorination is a method to purify the water by adding chlorine tablet or bleaching powder in the water. So next we have the types of water pollution. What are the types of water pollution? First is surface water pollution. As it is clear from the name, it is the surface water or the natural water resource of Earth, and these water can be polluted in number of ways. This is known as water pollution, means surface water. Next is underground water. The water found underground in the soil and under rocks, okay, that is mainly for drinking. Many times a well built in excess, this is called the pollution. Next is microbiological water pollution. वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस वॉट आर माइक्रोबायो वॉट इज माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो द माइक वेन द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म प्रेजेंट इन द वॉटर एंड कोज डिसीजेज दैट वॉटर इज नोन एज कंटेमिनेटेड और पोल्यूटेड वॉटर दैट कैन कोज मैनी डिसीजेज सच एज कोलरिया. ठीक है. सो दीज आर माइक्रोबायोलॉजिकल डिसीजेज और द डिसीजेज कोज बाय द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. नेक्स्ट इज इंडस्ट्रियल वाटर पोल्यूशन. एंड इट इज़ क्लियर फ्रॉम द नेम इंडस्ट्रियल. सो द वॉटर इज कंटेमिनेटेड बाय इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट और बाय द इंडस्ट्रीज एज द पोल्यूटेड वाटर और यू कैन से द पेस्टिसाइड्स आर यूज इन द फार्मिंग एंड टू कंट्रोल द वीड्स इंसेक्ट फंगी runs of these pesticide can cause the water pollution. Means these pesticides or weedicides can react can go to the drinking water at contaminated and that water is not good for humans. So oil spills are also an example of water pollution. Next, causes of water pollution. First is sewage. So sewage is the first cause given to the water pollution. So sewage is a term used for waste water that often contain urine and laundry waste. Untreated sewage water can contaminate the environment and cause diseases like diarrhea. Sewage is carried away from the home quickly and hygienically through sewage pipes. Sewage is treated in water treatment plants and the waste of often disposed in the sea. Next is industrial. We already discussed. Next is nuclear waste. Nuclear waste is the waste that is produced by radioactive materials. Okay, so that is nuclear waste. Next, very important is eutrophication. Now, what is eutrophication? Eutrophication is the phenomena when the aquatic ecosystem become enriched with nutrients. This can be a problem in marine habitat such take the intent. Let me discuss it in on the notebook. So as this is a water source and the nutrient or any chemical that enrich it in the nutrients goes to the water and become a layer over it. So this nutrient layer over water is known as algal bloom. And this how it is harmful for humans and it is harmful for aquatic life. The nutrients are essential for plants growth and development. Fertilizer are often used in farming. Sometimes these fertilizers runs off into nearby water causing an increase of nutrient level. This cause to go and reproduce more rapidly result in algal bloom. Okay, the aquatic plants grow more because there is a soluble nutrients in the water. The algae may use up all oxygen in the water leaving none of the marine and also this algae bloom blocks the sunlight and the underwater plant does not get the essentials like photosensitive marine plants and water surface. Some algae even produce toxic that are harmful for aquatic life. So it is all about eutrophication. Next, effects of water pollution. What are the effects of water pollution? Heavy metals from industrial process can accumulate nearby lakes and rivers that are toxic. Also, the toxic compound damage the health of aquatic animals. Microbiological pollution from sewage result in infection. Organic matter nutrient can increase the aromatic algae or algae bloom. Sulfate particles can cause acid rain. Suspended particles in fresh water lower the quality of drinking water. Next is Ganga Action Plan. So Ganga Action Plan was launched by the Government of India in 1985 in order to reduce the pollution in river Ganga. So that is all about how it the cabinet approved the Ganga in 1985. So what are the what are the aims of Ganga Action Plan? First one is interception and diversion of wastewater reaching to river. Okay. Next is installation of sewage treatment plants and treatment of wastewater. Next, solid waste management means the solid waste that is going to toward the river. First of all, we have to stop it. Installation of electric cement means the river front development. So these are the 8 aims of Ganga Action Plan. Next, we have the industrial water treatment. In the industrial water treatment, we have 3 steps. First one is, the first step is primary phase. This is where some of the suspended solid particles and inorganic material is removed by using of filters. Means, first of all, we use filters. Secondly, the treatment involves the reduction of organic matter. This is done with the use of biological filters. Firstly, we have the filters to remove the solid. Then we have the filters to remove the biological substance. Process the naturally degrade the organic waste material. Third, we have the final stage of treatment is tertiary phase, after which the water can be used. Almost all solid particles are removed from water and chemical additives. So this is the last or third step is tertiary phase of water treatment. Next, we have the water conservation. What are the ideas or situations we conserve water? First, conserve water by turning off the tap when it is running. Be careful about the water to in the sink and toilets. Use environment friendly household products. Take great care of the pesticides and fertilizer in the lawns. Plant more trees. Don't throw it into rivers, lakes and oceans. So that is all about your chapter pollution. Thank you.